I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
So sorry,
you say
smartest guy you ever faced in sparring or fighting, who is like super intelligent in the ring? Like, you know, they say some fighters have very high IQ.
Yeah. I don't know, because you know, like when I go into sparring sessions, I normally have a very high IQ myself, and I'm probably the fastest guy in boxing. So when I mean it's hard to say. You know, sometimes you get these amateur kids who probably don't even have a name, like a big name yet, who are probably more dangerous because they have nothing to lose and they're just going in the ring with you and throw some fast shots and some powerful shots go in as well. And they're very experienced, but they just never make it to that next level. But they might be good sparring partners, but they'll never be good fighters. So yeah, it just depends really. But I've sparred a lot of people, and even in the UK, you know, sparred with like world champions. And but I've just not, never, it's hard to say. Like, I mean, I have to say Manny Pacquiao was probably one of the best I've sparred with. But other than that, I've not really sparred with any world champions. I've trained with a lot, but I've never sparred with any guys up there.
How about who had the most freakish power that you ever sparred or fought?
You know who had a lot of power? Was, remember, Benavides?
Yeah.
Was it Benavides? Had a lot of power.
You guys did a lot of sparring.
We did a lot of sparring. I was like 135 then as well, and about 135 and 140. And I think he was fighting around in camp around 140 as well. I mean, he was strong. And he had that, you know what made him stronger was that long, wiry range he had. And shooting them shots in long and like a Tommy Hearns style he had. He was tall and bam, bam.
He has a great story right now.
Yeah, he made a comeback.
He got shot, you know that? He got shot in the leg.
No way.
I've talked to him about this. Yeah, he got shot in the leg numerous times. Ah. Came back this year, won in a very convincing way. So 2-3 more fights. He and Crawford got into it. They were yelling at each other.
Oh, really? So I remember his brother who's a world champion now.
Yeah.
What's his name? David.
David, yeah.
David was a short, fat kid in the gym.
250 pounds. Now he's 168.
And we see him in the gym. Lovely guy he was.
Yeah.
And look at how he's come on and become a great fighter and become a world champion. But yeah, Benavides, his dad was there also coaching him and helping him out as well.
Very nice guy.
But yeah, you know, good family, good people. I mean, they helped me a lot in training when I was getting ready for a lot of fights. But the kid was strong. And yeah, he has come from a crazy story. He's had the last couple of years for him have been very difficult. But I'm happy to see him back in the ring.
Doctors told him you're not going to walk.
Really?
And now he's doing his thing, and you know.
Is he gonna fight again then?
Yeah, he fought recently and won.
Did he?
And then afterwards, he got into it with Crawford.
Wow, so he wants to fight. Is he still campaigning at 147? Or
yep, 147. He really wants Crawford.
Wow, and he's stronger. I mean, look, he's very strong. You can feel his power through this 40-ounce gloves. I mean, let alone when he wears 8 or 10.
Yeah, no, he won by knockout.
Not a good fighter, man.
So this is the view you have every day?
So we drive to the gym, this is the view we have. This is the, we get to see the water, the bay. And we always go past the Facebook office.
Stop in, say hello.
Yeah, I've stopped there a few times. I always get invited by a couple of the workers there. We know. And they always invite us to go by and see what's going on.
What's the Facebook, at Amir King Khan?
Oh, my Facebook is Amir Khan. The official page.
What does it have? How many followers?
I think that's about 5 million.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's a lot of people. That's more than some countries.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. Yeah. Yeah. You know, it's, I've been quite lucky. I mean, you know, with social media, it's given us all a platform. It's helped us all out. All those famous people, all those high profile people, it's social media, and it's all the fans that we have to thank, really. That's always been very supportive and very nice to my fans when they come over to me. You can never be bad to them. You can never say no to a picture, no to an autograph. It would always be nice to them, because without them, you won't be here. And they are part of that, being that 4 million, 5 million followers I have on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. And it's crazy how nowadays, anywhere you go in the world, as soon as you put it on your Facebook or your Twitter or anything, you always meet people. Who recognize and say, oh, come meet me, I'm a big fan. I'm like, wow, people know me. And like, I was in Kuala Lumpur, people knew I was in Malaysia, I was in different areas. I've been around the world, and there's always been people who I bumped into.
Let me ask you this, which celebrity surprised you the most that they were a fan of Amir Khan? Because you meet a lot of famous people. Anybody come up to you and say, I watch you, was it like David Beckham? Was it the Prince? What's the name of the...
Prince Williams.
Yeah, who was it? Who like surprised you that they knew you?
Oh yeah, I mean, I had Prince Williams and his wife, Kate. They met me and they were so happy to see me, shook my hand. And then I met the Queen.
How was that?
A couple of times. She's amazing. It's amazing. It was an honor to meet her. And then when I met Hillary Clinton in Washington, she knew who I was and she had a good little talk with me. And I used to have a passport problem every time I used to come into America. I used to
always get pulled over. I remember the Pauly Malignaggi fight. You were in Canada.
Yeah, so I told her this. This was after I qualified. This was like 2 years after. I said, look, I get problems every time I come into the US. And I mean, I come here. We have so many employed people. We work with so many people. We box here. And last thing I want is hassle at the airport. And she says, can give me your passport details. I'll make sure it's all done. You'll be fine. From then on, I never
That's
problem.
Amazing. Shout out to Hillary for taking care of you. She came close to being president. First woman president.
Almost. She was there. But other than that, I mean, I've had like famous footballers like Ronaldo and other footballers who have come to see me fight. Obviously, and watch my fights and when they were playing for Manchester and other teams and all that. So,
do they ever want to spar you? Do they ever say, hey, let's get... Because you could play soccer. I've seen you play football.
I'm about 2 feet, two left feet, man. I'm the worst footballer going.
I can't play soccer.
I play celebrity ones. Like, in the UK, we play celebrity. Like, we have people like Vinnie Jones and all that. I'm fast, but fall over the ball, man. I'm really bad. I've had a few fighters who few footballers, soccer players who want to come in the boxing ring and fight, but I advise them not to. I always tell them, guys, it's not your sport. Just kick a football around. You don't want to be punched around the ring. So that's Facebook, by the way, guys.
That's Facebook's headquarters.
Yeah, so you'll see the sign on the right hand side coming up. So that's the headquarters where everything happens. And
what's the name? Like,
and this is where the big logo is that people always take pictures of.
Oh, that's better. Like.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for them to do the not like button.
Yeah, it's a like button. Yeah, so it was the like button. Yeah.
One thing I was going to say. So right now, Amir Khan, you started at 17. Did you ever think it would get this big? Actually, no. Sha, what age did you take him to the gym?
He's 8 years old first time he walked into the ring.
8 years old.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest with you, I never dreamt that he'd be here today. But I mean, the only reason he went into the gym was because he was a hyperactive kid, full of energy, just to burn his energy, keep him busy. But he loved it so much. But then, you know something? He worked the other way around because we said to him, if you mess around, we're not going to go to the gym. So he was behaving and it changed him completely, give him discipline, you know?
Yeah. So Elie, talking about my social media, you're my... Snapchat now.
Shout out to everybody. Amir Khan's one of the coolest people in boxing, if not the coolest. Make sure to tune in April 21st.
And watch that channel. What's your channel?
ES News.
Check him out, guys.
ES News on YouTube. Lots of videos coming.
Elie Seckbach, the main man in camp today, reporting.
Hey, every day 30,000 people tell me how much they hate me.
No way.
But it's okay. Amir, on social media, you know how you talked how social media brings stuff out?
Yeah.
But it also lets people hide behind accounts and talk. But it's in tens of thousands. But it's okay. They're watching.
You're right. You're 100% right. You're always going to have haters. And it's all about making sure that... It's about making sure that... are you going the right way, Doc?
Yeah. We've missed it, actually. But we don't problem.
No, it's the next one.
Oh, we still got to go further.
Are you sure?
Yeah, you're right. Meanwhile, he's doing the interview.
Come on, Doc. Come on, Doc. You got a sat nav, you got a steering wheel, and I'm telling you how to drive. Sorry, what were you talking about again?
I'm a bad limo.
I'm saying how social media. Oh
yeah,
social.
You're always gonna get criticism. The day you don't get criticism is you're doing something wrong in a way, because people don't want to see you. People are bored of you.
Two of us.
But I get criticism every day. People say, oh, you this, you that, but they're still talking about me.
That's true. That's a good thing.
But I mean, yourself as well. You probably get a lot of criticism for your videos and stuff. But as long as people are talking about you,
I'm good.
That's the main thing. Let them say you're the worst. From cameraman, let them say that I'm the worst boxer. I can't throw a jab, and they can beat me up. Fine. I mean, you know,
it's all good.
It's all good, man. As long as I'm doing it because I love the sport. I'm not doing it for them. I'm doing it because I love the sport, and it keeps me humble and also keeps me disciplined.
Are we gonna see any tricks today with the hands, with the bottles, with the?
You like the bottle trick, don't you?
That was crazy.
See, I did that bottle trick. Took me a long time to do, man. But yeah, I managed it. So I did it twice. I did it once in Pakistan. And I did it once for the once in the UK. So I've done it twice. And they paid me a lot of money for it. So
Red Bull should pay you too. They should sponsor you.
You know, I get a lot of food drinks from them when I'm back in the UK. But I think I'm only stick to water now. I'm a water man.
Water's good.
Water, keep it good and clean.
What's the last movie you saw?
Last movie?
You have a chance to see anything? Or
you know what we did? We saw what movie was that Italian one me and Bill were watching? It was a gangster one.
Goodfellas.
That's a good movie. That's a really good movie.
So I remember seeing it a long time ago. I was watched it again while I was in camp. So while we were in camp, my friend just left now, Bill. He's on me with me all the time and we always watch movies and stuff together. So he put that on and that was a good movie, man.
That is a good movie. It's a classic.
That's a proper classic.
Because
I never watch movies when I'm back in England. But only time I watch movies is when I'm here. Because I have time to kill. In the UK, you don't have time. You're always getting pulled left, right, center.
Sha, when they make the Amir Khan movie, what's the title?
Well, they've got the made one.
The King.
The King? They made one when you were 17.
They've done a documentary.
There's a documentary. It's going to be like a movie. It's gonna
be remember soon. Those guys.
You remember them guys,
yeah,
and it's going to be really good.
They're finishing it off now, the final cut, you know.
Yeah, so that's going to be it. And I think that'll be nice because people get to see the real side of me and see what my life's all about. It shows all the behind the scenes at home with family, with friends, and also boxing, training, and fight nights. So it's got everything that you want.
They invested a lot in that.
They
do 24/7.
I was getting sick of them.
after today, it's like,
It was good to do, and so that's like the that's like the movie. It's gonna be like a movie, really.
Well, I can't wait. I told them it could do very good in award shows and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Yep.
Doctor, are we almost there?
We're almost there. 2.6 miles.
That's cool.
See, that's what we call it. He fixes me up, and then he wants to drive the car as well, and he goes, I'll drive you there.
Just so you don't
need to get hurt. Doc's taking good care of me, man.
Making sure I'm alright.
But Doc's been with me for a couple of years, making sure that I'm always fit and strong.
It's important to have the right team.
So he flies in and out, camps, spends like a week with me, and then goes back to DC, make sure that I'm fixed and ready for the hard work coming.
People watch a fighter; they only think you step in the ring. They don't realize.
But they don't see what happens behind the scenes. It's like wake up in the morning. You got morning session. You got night session. You got diets. You got nutrition. Then you got your massages. I mean, it's tough, and that's why I like to get away from my comfort zone, being at home in England. I like to come to America where I'm just pure focused on training.
What do you eat during training camp? Do you have a special diet that you do, or is it the same diet?
Well, I have a chef who comes in and does everything. He comes in, he'll make my breakfast first. So, we balance it with enough carbs and enough protein, and then we have a lot of vegetables and a lot of salads as well, because it's really good for you especially when you're making weight. So he knows what to do. I leave that to the experts. Like, for example, Docs does his work on me. He's an expert, so I'm not going to tell him what to do. He knows what to do. Then I got a masseuse. She's going to do work on my body and tell me exactly what I need to do and what I don't do. Then I've got my chef. He makes the food. There's no point in me questioning him. I've got a boxing trainer who'll do all the boxing workout. So everyone has their own specific area that they have to go.
They all do their part and it comes together.
Yeah.
What fight is this for you in your career? Number one. How many fights have you had?
Me? How many fights have I had? That's a gym there.
There it is. Water.
Boom.
It's a big gym?
Big gym, yeah. So, what
like, is this your 40th fight? 35?
Nah, this is my 37.
Getting up there? That's a lot of fights, Amir.
100%. I mean, looking back at it now, when I started... But mind you, I mean, I probably would have been a 40, but because I've taken some time off and my hand injuries and stuff like that, I'm on 36. But yeah, a lot of fights, man.
That's crazy. When you first came to America, what did you have, 17 fights?
No, when I first came to America, I'd have had 22. 22? No, sorry, 24. Yeah, I fought Paulie on my 24th fight.
That was a big night
for me. Like my first debut in, it was at the Madison Square, and my first fight in America, which was New York.
You had to go straight.
It was amazing. No, it's left, isn't that?
So right now, the workout, and then dinner, and call it a day.
No, we'll do probably a little workout again tonight. We'll do like with Tony. We'll do some strength work or maybe some abs.
Oh, either way.
Abs or neck. Left. Neck work. So Tony always keeps us going as well. We'll do some like abs tonight and neck. Yeah, we just change it around. I mean, when we're here, you know, we try to maximize the facilities that we have here in San Francisco. Another treatment as well with Doc. He's gonna fix me up again for tomorrow. So all we do is beat the body up and then we fix it again. We beat the body up, we fix it.
Who do you have right now as a top 5 pound for pound?
Top 5 pound for pound, there's some great names. I think you've got people like Mike Garcia. I think he's amazing. You've got Lemonchenko. You've got top five. You've got Wilder there as well. Mayweather's gone. I mean, you got Triple G. So that's four, and you got Crawford. End of the day, you know, is I know Crawford's moving up a weight, and you know it's time to tell. But what he's done in the previous fights, so, I mean, the 140 division and everything else has been amazing. So those guys are top fighters, man. Honestly, like you could see. I mean, especially with Triple G as well, having that tough fight against Canelo. I don't know if Canelo was on something on that fight, but you know they've done it the hard way. And it's funny because a lot of us turned, like I think Triple G turned professional around the same time as me, 2004 or 2005. So this is like our last chapter of our career, really.
But he stayed at 60 the whole time. You started at 35. 40.
He stayed at 60 all the way.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
From day one.
Oh, wow. So, yeah, I moved from 135 to 140.
Where you won a title. 140, won a title.
Yeah.
47.
Yeah, so I moved up and down. Even fought to one. I fought in the middleweight category as well, 155. If it wasn't for me. But, yeah, I've gone up and down weight divisions and stuff. But sometimes it is good just to stay the weight that you feel your strongest at and you feel comfortable at as well. And I think Triple G's done that, so, and it's worked for him. You know, you can see how he fights and how strong he's at the power at that weight, at the speed at that weight, so it's perfect for him. Instead of going up and down a weight, I think it does kind of make it a little bit harder. But you know, the reason I went up and down a weight is just to challenge myself as well and to see what it's like fighting these bigger guys and stronger guys and just get the feel of it.
If you stayed at 35,
it'd be, I mean, if I stayed at 35, I mean, I was a big good fight out of 35. I mean, fought the likes of Black Barrera and some big names. I fought at 135 and I had that knockout power as well. I hurt a lot of guys. Yeah, not a lot of people at 135. I think only maybe 2-3 fights went the distance. Other than that, I mean, I knocked a lot of people out. So 135 was a good weight for me, but it was just so hard for me to make because I was only 17, 18 at the time.
Yeah.
My body was growing and when I got a little bit older, my body filled out a little bit, so it was hard for me to stay at that weight.
I gotta ask you this. Mayweather says he might take out an MMA license. He's gonna train MMA for 6 to 8 months. You're big in MMA. You have an MMA company that you're with. What's it called? The Fight League, right?
Yeah, it's called Super Fight League.
Super Fight League. What would you tell Mayweather about MMA, given your knowledge and experience in that field?
Yeah, I mean, it's not an easy sport to get into. I mean, I know you might be a good boxer, but MMA is like a totally different feel, man. It's a different sport. Getting took down to the ground, and then you have to survive while you're on the floor. You're getting punched, and at the same time, you're getting in locks, getting, you know, put in locks and stuff. It's very hard. It's not easy. It's probably one of the toughest sports out there. Then you might think, okay, I'm gonna watch their hands, and I'm gonna see what punches they throw. But then you'll get a kick to the head.
And then choked out.
So I think if I was Mayweather, just enjoy your money, man. Sit back and don't do it, because you never know, that might be the last fight you have. You know,
right.
It might be the last time you ever get to enjoy your money, because it's a very dangerous sport. It's not easy. I mean, one wrong hit to the head, one wrong hit to any part of your body, that's you done.
It's different. There are kicks. There's things that you don't see that you're not used to in the ring where they practice.
I own the Super Fight League, and I've been to events there, and the stuff I've seen, and I've been like, wow, you know. Even sometimes, the guys who are the most dangerous are the ones who are not as experienced or not big names, because they're the ones who will just pull a kick out from nowhere or an elbow from nowhere, and then boom, you'll get hit with it. You know, it's the inexperienced fighters that you want to be more wary about, because they're the ones who are more dangerous. So I just think that, you know, it'd be very difficult for someone like a fighter to go into, especially like Mayweather. And I think Mayweather is not really a strong inside fighter. He knows how to stop, but when you've got both your legs, knees, and hands you can use while he's trying to stop you and he'll grapple you, impossible.
Now, speaking of MMA, Nate Diaz, one of the biggest superstars in the UFC, in the MMA world, he trained alongside you. What do you remember from those days training alongside Nate
Diaz? He's a strong guy, man. I mean, Nate's a beast. He's come to the gym, and you just get straight to hard work. You just go straight to the gym, push himself hard, and then you step in the ring and start sparring. Before you know it, like, he's done like 10 rounds of sparring, and he spar with whoever they put him in with. He's a very tough guy, man. And you know, even if he might be sparring guys who are good professional fighters, and they might be hitting him with some big shots, but he'll keep on coming. I'm like, what's this guy made out of? You know what I mean? Because he's very tough. But I've been watching him and following him a long time. I think a brilliant fighter.
He told me that he's a boxer stuck in the MMA world. He started boxing at 15.
Yeah,
he loves boxing.
Yeah, he loves boxing. He was training with us, Virgil and everyone. He was training in the gym. And yeah, he was doing well. I mean, he's strong. That's one thing I know about him. And he takes a good shot, and he can put some good shots together well.
Southpaw.
And hurt you as well. He's southpaw. So it's quite, you know, all southpaws are awkward. But yeah, he's very powerful, you know, that way. And when I see him sparring with some good professional guys who are up there to become world champions, like the fighters like from Fara and other fighters, he did really well against them.
How would he do as a pro boxer? Does he win a title?
Maybe a smaller title, yeah. A world title might be a little bit too much to ask for, but to win maybe a medium title, I think that could be possible, yeah.
But he would do good.
He'll do well, yeah. I mean, he's not going to be easy to beat, but look, this is boxing where one punch could maybe change a fight, so he could be up against a world title guy who might be better skillfully than him, but he might just catch him, boom, and knock him out, so then win the world title. So this, you can't ever think that he's not going to win anything. Anything can happen in boxing.
Let me ask you this, Amir. You have the fastest hands in boxing. Which opponent, either fighting or sparring, you were impressed with their hand speed? Was there anyone that surprised you? Because your hand speed is different level.
Manny Pacquiao. Yeah, he's quick. So he's one of the guys who I was very impressed by his speed and his movement. But not only is his footwork that kind of helps him be fast. I mean, he's got short arms, so he likes to throw a lot of mid-range punches, and he's not scared to throw them shots. I don't know about now. That was when I sparred with him in 2000, and I think it was 2008, 9, 10 when we started sparring. But after that, we stopped sparring because then it got too competitive. But you know, at that time, he was very confident where he'll throw 2-3 shots, even though he knows that there might be a shot coming at him, he'll dodge that and go under it or something. But now, as he's getting older, I think maybe I've been watching his last few fights. I don't think the speed is not like it used to be. But he always gets caught with more shots than he used to get caught with. You know, it stays in there, but before we hit, bang, 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 and it'll be out.
Yeah,
you
a guy
don't see
like
him.
Like
he'll get back in again. His feet work fast, but I think his feet have slowed down a little bit.
A guy like Jeff Horn in the past wouldn't last with him at all, not a round.
Jeff Horn would even do a round with him. I mean, Manny would walk right through him and run rings around him, and probably stop him in late rounds. But I think, look, this boxing, I mean, we all hit our sell-by date, and we just have to make sure you know when it's your... when it's time for you to...
Manny just underestimated it, to be honest with you, and I don't think he trained as hard to when he fought Horn. I think if he were to rematch, I think he'd have beat him.
Rematch, because he was going to fight Crawford, but they postponed that fight because Crawford had a hand injury.
Yeah.
But Shad, the thing is that Manny's team were saying before the fight, only way Manny loses if he trips on himself walking into the ring.
Correct. That's
you
what
don't
saying.
Say that.
Yeah, but yeah, that's what I'm true. Saying. They were overconfident, and I think they were underestimating him, and I don't think Manny trained as hard as he normally does. and that's why he got beat, you know.
I mean, who's the smartest guy you ever sparred or fought? Like, who just impressed you with ring gentlemanship, intelligence?
Who I sparred with?
Yeah, or fought. That was super smart in the ring, like, that has impressed you.
Well, let me just sit on this. Where's that gym now? What's it? What area is it in?
Nobody knows.
Westfield.
Left here.
Shah, do you enjoy training camp?
It's got to be done on it. It's work, isn't it, really? Do I enjoy it? No. But, you know, it's something you got to be here and be here. And it's only a short one anyway, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
A couple of months and that's it, you know?
And then it's back to business.
Yeah.
What do you think of Phil Greco?
He's a strong guy, you know, he's going to come to fight. It's not an easy fight, it's a tough fight, you know? A lot of people think, oh, it's an easy fight. It's not an easy fight at all. And he's going to be up for it. You know, the thing is, he's had so much time to prepare for this fight as well. So he's going to be ready.
It's like when he fought against Spence and he fought against Sean Porter. He said he only had like maybe 3-4 weeks to prepare for the fight. Whereas with this, we've given him a full 10-week training camp to get ready. And obviously he's got a bit of a mouth on him. He likes to talk trash. But we just have to kind of be smart and go in there and just outbox him, and he can do what he wants. He can train the way he wants for this fight, but he's not got the skill set or the speed or the power to hurt me, so I'm not going to let him do that, you know. I'm just going to be smart in there and do what I do best.
And just April 21st is the date?
April 21st
Liverpool.
Is the date. In Liverpool.
It's a blue-collar city, right? That's what its reputation is. I don't know, I've never been there, but...
No, it's all right. I mean,
it's a nice city?
Yeah, it's a lovely city, yeah. You'll like it.
I know their soccer team is very popular.
They got two teams there which are big. I mean, you got Everton and you got Liverpool.
Liverpool used to be the best team, right? One of the best? And they kind of fell down a little.
No, they're still doing well. They're still doing well, yeah.
There's a guy named Kenny Dalglish.
Dalglish, yeah. I was in a celebrity football match with him.
Really? Did you
win? Yeah, playing. He was on the other side team. I remember when I had the ball and he'd come and just barge me away like I was flying. He was very strong. I'm a little bit scared of the fight. I'm just scared that the studs might stand on my feet with them studs to break my toes, man. I'm like, forget that.
Thank you for the ride back.
All right.
My pleasure.
You're watching Amir Khan Behind the Scenes, another day at the office. Always hard work.
Another day at the gym.
I just go and lock the doors.
Very important. Yeah. Should I keep the door open or?
I don't need more.
So Amir, what's your day like normally? You wake up early.
Normally wake up, we go for a run. We do like a strength conditioning session. And then we'll come home, we'll have some food. Dr. Rosa will do some work on me, make sure I'm alright. Loosen me up for a little bit, we'll do like a stretch. And then I'll get ready for my boxing session. So now it's the boxing session, we're on our way to what's the name of the gym?
Undisputed.
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 So Undisputed Gym.
It's a cool name.
It's a nice. Oh, you want to see the gym?
Yeah,
beautiful.
The gym is
really
nice.
The gym is like one of the best gyms I've ever
been. Except for the Amir Khan gym in Bolton.
No, this is different. This is a very commercial, but at the same time, it's a good gym where you can get a good sweat on as well. So yeah, amazing. You'll see it yourself. So we're going to go there, we're going to do some training sessions.
Sorry.
Pipe work.
Whatever you call it.
You call it mitts or do you call it pads?
I call it mitts, but in England, I think,
pads.
Pads. How excited are people in the UK for your fight? Is the buzz crazy?
I mean, the buzz was massive, yeah. It's like, even on Sky, Sky's been over 2-3 times to do like a couple of weeks of training over here.
But they signed you there. I hope they do that.
Yeah, so we've done a big deal with Sky and also Matchroom. So I'm really excited to be back on Sky and also be back on UK soil to put on a big performance on for the UK fans. They've not seen for ages. 5 years is a long time to not fight there, so, yeah.
You started there. No one gave you a shot in the Olympics. You were 17 years old. Yeah. You've been in this game for many years.
I've been in the game a long time, man. You know what? I've been just grinding all the way through, man. You know, I mean, there's been good days, there's been tough days, but I've been grinding and it's going really well. You know, I've just been working hard.
Thank you, everybody. We're here in the limo.